We have seen that DRAM accesses are slow because really we have to use the row decoder to select the row, then get those bits onto the bit lines, then sense what's on the bit lines and so on. And only then we get the values in the row buffer from which we can read them and send them back to the processor. But not all of the DRAM accesses have to be that slow. So we will discuss a technique called fast page mode that makes some of the DRAM accesses a lot faster than others. Remember our organization of the DRAM. We use some part of the address to select a row. That row of bits gets output to the sense amplifier. We then latch those into the row buffer. And then from the row buffer, we use the column address to select a bit to output. And then from the row buffer, the column decoder, using the column address, selects the actual bit to output. Note that once we have done all of this, the row buffer can retain the entire row. So if we want to read a bit from the same row, we don't need to go through the whole row address, sense amplifier, row buffer mechanism again. What we can do is simply keep what we have in the row buffer and just change the column address. Then the bit simply gets read out of the row buffer without a new DRAM access. So this approach of finding what we need in the row buffer is called fast page mode. It's not called fast row mode just because some people prefer to call a memory row a page. It usually has thousands of bits, so people call it a page. It has nothing to do with the pages that we use for virtual memory. It's just a name for something that has a lot of bits in this case. So fast page mode works this way. We do what is called opening a page. That amounts to providing a row address, selecting a row, sense amplification of what the cells output, and latching what we get into the row buffer. Now we can do a series of reads and writes to the page, which really happens to the row buffer. We can read or we can modify bits in the row buffer. Finally, when we want to do something on another row in memory, we do what is called closing the page. We now use the sense amplifiers to write back to the row what we have in a row buffer. It could be different data than what we read because we have been modifying it also in between. And this way, if we want to do a single read, we would have to open a page, do one read, then close the page to write back things to our memory cells because of the destructive read. And then finally, we have to do what is called closing the page, which amounts to writing the data from the row buffer back into the row from which we read it. So if we want to do a single memory read, we would open a page. The data is now in the row buffer and no longer in the row. Do the read from the row buffer and then close the page, which causes the data to be sent back and written back to the row. We can do a single write, which amounts to opening a page. The data now ends up in the row buffer. We do a single write, so we modify a bit in the row buffer, and then we close the page, which causes the row to get the new data. And some of the bits may not have changed, which is why we had to read in the first place. But we can do a lot more than just one operation in between opening and closing a page. So usually, it's advantageous to open a page, do all the reads and writes that we can to that page before we close the page and open another page.